गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। टुडे विल डिस्कस अबाउट इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम मशीनिंग। ए रिसेंट इनोवेशन इन द फील्ड ऑफ मेटल प्रोसेसिंग हैज बीन द यूज ऑफ हाई एनर्जी डेंसिटी बीम्स। इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम इज वन ऑफ द सच सोर्सेस। मेजर यूज ऑफ दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम हैज बीन द फील्ड ऑफ वेल्डिंग टेक्नोलॉजी वेयर हाई कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ एनर्जी इज प्रोवाइडेड। Considerable advantages like deep penetration, low distortion, clean welds, which is not possible by conventional arc welding. Facilities provided by these heat sources, particularly in electron beam machining, laser beam machining. Availability of energy in the form of a controlled energy pulses, capability to vary the current density, very fine beam focusing to small diameter to a longer focal length as compared to laser beam. If required, the clean atmosphere is evacuated electron beam machining chamber. Applications of electron beam machining besides welding are high speed perforation of small die holes, through thickness cutting of any kind of material, engraving of metals and ceramics, thin film machining, surface treatment including surface alloying. Whereas hole drilling and surface machining capabilities of electron beam machining are high speed perforation of any kind of material, performing perforation of small diameter holes in a thick material, drilling of taper holes, perforation of inclined holes, non-circular holes, engraving of metal, ceramic and vaporized layers, machining of thin film to produce resistor network in IC chip manufacturing. In the field of welding, negligible distortion, very high narrow deep welds are possible in this case. This is the figure. This is the figure of schematic diagram of electron beam machining. Here you can see a cathode. Here this is the cathode. This, when a potential difference is given, 30 to 40 kilovolts DC power is supplied to this cathode. Electron starts liberating from this cathode due to thermionic emission of electrons are going to liberate from this cathode, and these electrons starts moving towards the anode, and this passes through lens, and it is made to pass through this magnetic lens and deflecting coil. Finally, because of this lens, the electron beams which are liberated from this electron cathode are made to concentrate at one point due to the lens provided, magnetic lens provided there in the gun, electron gun. So finally, all beams travel as a single beam and touches the workpiece, which is kept at the vacuum chamber. So electron beam, as soon as electron beam touches the workpiece, the electrons electrons strike the workpiece. Because of this, heat is going to generate. That heat we utilize to melt the work material in this process. See, this is the high voltage cable, and this is the grid bias. This is the primary anode, electron beam, and this is the deflecting coil and focusing lens. So this focusing lens will make the beams to focus on to a single point. So it will make all beams to travel as a single beam and made to fall onto the workpiece. It consists of a tungsten cathode which is heated by low voltage current. On heating, it eliminates electrons mainly by thermionic emission. These electrons move towards anode, which is kept at a potential difference of 30 to 200 volts, kilovolts. Such high voltage accelerates the electrons to high velocity. The use of grid around the cathode helps to further narrowing the beam, and this grid is also used for controlling the beam current. The beam passes through central hole in anode. A tungsten diaphragm with a small central hole separates this part of the gun from the rest of the portion. Light microscope helps in focusing the beam on workpiece initially. The magnetic lens further converges the beam into narrow spot on the workpiece. A beam deflecting coil can be used to deflect the beam further, either into the different spots on the workpiece or any moment it along the contour. See, this is how metal is removed from the workpiece. A beam is coming on focus on the workpiece. Because of heat generated on the workpiece, metal starts melting, and it metal melts as the beam focuses on the workpiece. So this is the depth of penetration into the beam workpiece. So metal melts and it molten metal is made to evaporate from the hole generated by the electron beam. So a material vaporizes in an explosion and blows the molten metal out of the hole. See, molten metal is getting evaporated, is blown out of the hole like this. Electron beam workpiece placed in a vacuum chamber, high voltage electron beam directed towards workpiece. Electron of energy of electron beam melts, vaporizes selected region of the workpiece. Electron beam moved by deflecting coil and a similar process in electron beam welding. See, these are the photos. This is the electron beam focused on the workpiece. It makes a hole in the workpiece. These are the different photos for electron beam machining. The electron beam is generated in an electron beam gun. Electron beam gun provides high voltage electrons over a very small spot size. Electron beam machining is required to be carried out in a vacuum. Otherwise, the electron would interact with the air molecules. Thus, they would lose their energy and cutting ability. Thus, the workpiece to be machined is located under the electron beam and is kept under vacuum. The high energy focus electron beam is made to impinge on workpiece with a spot size of 10 to 100 micrometers. Kinetic energy of electron, high energy electron is electrons is converted to heat energy as the electrons strike the workpiece. See, this is surfacing. This is the vacuum chamber. This is the electron beam gun, and beam is generated. And this is the wire, and wire is kept onto the workpiece so that the beam melts the wire and it will melt the metal, and it is made to spread on the other surface so that surfacing can be done using this electron beam. The electron beam gun generates a high energy beam up to 3000 watts. The beam melts each layer of powder metal to be desired geometry. Extremely fast beam translated with no moving parts. High beam power density, high melt rate up to 80 centimeters per hour. That is productivity. Vacuum process eliminates impurities and yield excellent material properties. High process temperature, that is 650 degrees for titanium, low residual stresses and no need of further heat treatment. In thermal type EBM, the rate at which material is vaporized can be calculated by R is equal to rho P by W, where rho is the cutting efficiency, P is the power and W is the total equation. The melting efficiency is normally low, that is 2 to 20%, and depends upon the cross section area of the cut. Forces in electron beam machining are electron pressure, back pressure of evaporating atoms, surface tension, hydrostatic pressure of the molten metal.